Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's session of Commencement 101. This is an opportunity for us to go ahead and discuss commencement, what's to expect about commencement on the day of commencement. At this time, we'll be talking to everything regarding commencement, but first, we want to wish you congrats. Congrats to all the class.
Congratulations.
Yeah, class of 2024, we're so proud of you and so excited for each and every one of you and be able to celebrate you all. Before we get into the day of commencement, there's a couple of things that we find it very important to be able to cover with each one of you. We want to be able to know and understand the difference between graduation versus commencement. And I think that those are two words that get used fairly often. We want to make sure that we understand that graduation is the completion of your academic degree requirement. And commencement's the fun part. Commencement's the ceremony. Commencement's the time that we get to celebrate each and every one of you. So just know there, when we say commencement, we're referring to the actual ceremony. Your degree, on the day of commencement, you will not be receiving your diploma. Your diploma will be received via mail to your physical address 4 to 6 weeks after grades are posted. So just know that on the day of commencement, you won't be receiving anything, but you'll receive your diploma again 4 to 6 weeks after your grades have been posted. Let's talk about what's on your diploma. Your full name is on your diploma, and it's important that you look at your student portal to see what your full name is. Some people may have a maiden name or new married name, so if you want to make any changes, make sure you log into mycsudh.edu to make any edits. In addition to that, you'll have your degree major listed on there. If a minor applies to you, you'll have your minor. And for those that have university honors, again, congrats to you all. But your university honors will show on there. If you have two degrees, a Bachelor's of Arts and a Bachelor's in Science, you will be receiving two separate diplomas. So just look out for those. Those with university honors would have received an email by now from commencement at csudh.edu letting you know that your medallion is ready to get picked up at the bookstore. If that is you, that means that you had a minimum of 36 units here at Dominguez Hills and a minimum GPA of a 3.4 here at Dominguez Hills, but also anywhere else. And so if you had any courses taken at a community college or somewhere else prior to Dominguez Hills, those grades are also accounted for. And you can see the breakdown here, anyone between a 3.4 and a 3.59, it's a cum laude, a 3.6 to a 3.79 is magna, and a 3.8 to a 4.0 is summa cum laude. So to all of you who've achieved university honors, congrats. If you haven't done so, it's important that you stop by the bookstore, you call the bookstore, you go on our website, but you must purchase your regalia fairly soon. So I want to encourage you, if you haven't done it, go ahead and purchase that. For those of you obtaining a bachelor's, the cost of it is 50. For those obtaining your master's, it's 107, but that does include your hood. Fun opportunities for each and every one of you. Our vendor will be on site, Grad Images, and they will love to photograph you at no cost to you, so there's no sitting fee. They'll be on site on Monday, May 6th through the 9th from 10 to 7 in LSU. An email will be sent out with a registration link, but walk-ins are welcome. So it's just a great time to have your photo taken. We do have a couple cultural celebrations. Their deadlines are coming up. April 19th will be their deadlines. But we are highlighting three of our cultural celebrations: API, Latin A, and Douglas Bethune. So if you're interested, make sure you register to participate in those. Now I'll go ahead and introduce you all to Sarah. She'll talk to you a little bit more about the day of commencement.
Hi everyone, super excited for all of you. I just wanted to give you some details as far as what to expect when you show up to the stadium and what you'll be doing step by step. So just a reminder, please arrive 90 minutes before your check-in. That's an hour and a half. You are going to enter and gather in the track and field. First of all, you'll park in lot six. Parking is free. ADA parking is available in lot six as well. And if you're taking any type of Uber or Lyft, drop off will be the same in lot six. Please keep in mind that at the top of this photo is lot six. At the bottom of this photo is the sport track and field. So this is where you'll be walking from and to. This is where you'll be lining up. You will line up according to your college. And this is where you'll be checking in as well. Please keep in mind that it is about a 6 to 8 minute walk from the parking lot six to the track and field. Comfortable shoes are highly recommended. I understand we want to look good, we want to look cute, but please keep that in mind. It's a long day. You're going to be there again an hour and a half before your ceremony. The ceremony lasts about an hour and a half, maybe longer. And so definitely think of comfortable shoes as you're preparing for this amazing day. Also dress according to the weather. Plan ahead if it's, going to be sunny, wear your sunscreen. Also, water will be on site for our students so we can stay hydrated throughout the event. We want to encourage you guys to have fun, but also just keep in mind the safety of yourself and others for the day of commencement. Grad images will also be on site. So you guys, as I mentioned before, will gather in the track and field where you will then process through the tunnel of the stadium. And then in the tunnel, Grad Images will be there to take your photo. Once you get into the tennis stadium, you will be also photographed once you are approaching the stage as your name will be called. And then when you walk across the street at the stage as your name will be called. So there will be three opportunities for photos. Just keep that in mind. You are on camera. And then for our graduate students, congratulations. Amazing job. You did it. Also, just keep in mind that when you go through the tunnel, make sure you have your hood on for your photos. Then when you go into the ceremony, you're going to have that hood off. You'll be holding that. Then as you approach the stage, you will hand over the hood and be hooded at that point. So something important to remember there because there's a lot of off and on. We also have private suites available at Dignity Health Sports Park Tennis Stadium. This is kind of a bird's eye view of what to expect your outlook to be. They are $75 a person with a five ticket minimum. And there's a contact number there for you guys to make those reservations. This just gives you a more private experience to enjoy with your families. There's also catering available in those suites as well. Now on to what not to do. There's a list or rather photos of a few items you may or may not think as obvious, but please keep the party at home, leave the alcohol at home. We also do not allow any noisemakers, such as blowhorns. Umbrellas are not prohibited, nor can your guests bring balloons. It does distract other people's views, so they ask that we do not bring those in. They will be confiscated if you do, so please keep those at home. Also, no pets Pets are not allowed in the stadium. No smoking of any kind, no vapes, no cigarettes, no e-cigarettes, and then no beach balls, unfortunately. Those will as well be confiscated. All of these items, as well as many more, are also available on the Dignity Health Sports Park website if you have questions as to what can or cannot be brought in. There will be a live stream available on the CSUDH homepage. For all six ceremonies. So if your friends or family are unable to make it, or you have loved ones from out of town, this is how they'll be able to still celebrate with you the day of. And please remember, again, as mentioned, there are six ceremonies total, three per day. If you must party, party at home. There's going to be a ceremony right after you, or was one right before you, and that turnaround needs to happen seamlessly and quickly. So we do ask that once the ceremony is over, you vacate the tennis stadium and then celebrate with your family and friends at home. There's also a lot of helpful information, a lot of what we mentioned today, as well as day of information, et cetera, on our iToro's app. And you just make sure that when you log on, you choose the user role student, and that will give you a lot of useful information as far as FAQs, family and friend information, parking, as I mentioned, everything basically that we've included today. The live stream will also eventually be available on there as well. And we are also open and welcome social media shares, Facebook, X, and do they still call it X, or is it Twitter still? Twitter X, and Instagram. So please follow, please like, please post. There's a hashtag there, CSUDHGrad24. We love the shares. And that will conclude our commencement 101 for you guys. If you have any questions, please feel free to email us at commencement@csudh.edu. We have direct access to that and check it daily. So if there's anything that you might not have heard today, please forward those questions to us and we'd be happy to answer them for you. So that wraps it up for our commencement 101. I think we both want to say congratulations, class of 2024. We look forward to celebrating with you, and we are so, so proud of you. Thank you guys for joining us.
Thank you, everyone.